Ladies and gentlemen, I am SidAlpha, and it's been quite a long time since I've spoken about Friday the 13th, the video game, in any of my videos, but the game and its developers have found their way into my videos multiple times since the game's release in early access in May of 2017, and while only a year has gone by, somehow it feels far longer to me, and due to recent news involving the game once again, it makes me feel glad that I do archive all of my screenshots and links for all of my videos. The most recent news involves a lawsuit surrounding the ownership of the rights to Friday the 13th, and for the first time since the game's release, it is embroiled in something potentially controversial that actually has nothing whatsoever to do with the game itself. Well, I should say, not directly related to the game itself, but this is one of the instances where the developers are in absolutely no fault here. I just want that made clear up front. I beat up the developers quite a lot over the past year, and to their credit, they've taken it on the chin like true adults and have remained actually quite amicable in their communications with me. There was the debacle with the accusations of a player sexually harassing a 12-year-old, which resulted in death threats being directed at the developers and one developer's parents. There was the issue with the developers failing to fulfill several Kickstarter backer rewards. There was the controversy with the developers banning people from the game, which at that time meant they would be unable to play at all. That is no longer the case, as they've brought new features on board, but there was a time where one could conceivably receive a ban for even accidentally making use of a known bug and being banned from a game that you paid money for with little to no recourse. The developers' over-moderation of their subreddit causing some Reddit mods to quit, the community backlash over the game making very little progress forward, and then learning that the developers were seemingly splitting their attention, working on another game at the same time as Friday the 13th, the reports of some YouTubers and Twitch streamers being granted special access to information that was supposed to be made privy to all backers, the promised physical copies of the game coming with a printed code and no disc, the list goes on and on. Now, some of this was undoubtedly the fault of the developers and their actions, or sometimes their inaction, and some of it was misunderstanding, while still more was born out of mere frustration out of what seemed to be very little progress being made on the game and people beginning to feel that it was some sort of cash grab. Now, I would like to note that I myself do not see the game as a cash grab, but I do find the developers to have been woefully unprepared for the success of the game. Its sudden meteoric rise in popularity created its own set of unique problems that, while they may have been more forgiving for a smaller game and a smaller budget, many gamers are far less forgiving when a game reaches the sales levels of your smaller AAAs, or even your larger AAAs. However, as I said before, this particular issue is one born of copyright. The current rights holder for the Friday the 13th franchise, Sean Cunningham, who was also the producer and director of the original film, is being sued by Victor Miller, who wrote the original film. Now, as reported by The Hollywood Reporter, Miller is suing under the 1976 Copyright Act, and this amendment to the copyright law allows authors or their heirs to terminate a copyright grant and reclaim ownership. While that amendment does exist, Cunningham claims that Miller wrote Friday the 13th under work for hire, and as such has no legal standing in this case. It sounds a bit like what Alex Maurer tried to do with Imago Softworks in the music for the game Star Mazer DSP. Regardless, as Gun Media and Ilphonic are developing the Friday the 13th video game under a license, the fact that the copyright is now in question puts the developers into a very difficult position, especially considering they were still making claims to release the single-player content that was promised in September of last year and still has not been delivered nearly a year later. However, I do feel it worth noting again that the single-player content was not a part of the originally proposed game, nor was it a stretch goal, something to which I had originally criticized the developers for its absence, but it was content that the developers just decided to do, as they had a lot of people buying the game and it was a very popular mode being asked for. It surprised me that they didn't have it to begin with, but their decision to include it after the fact did speak well of them on that score. Still, as they are operating under a license, they're continuing to produce content for the game while the true ownership of its copyright is in question, could put them into a legally actionable position, and as that was the case, they had announced a while ago that any further content would be put on hold. And when I asked Gun Media about it, they were unable to provide me any additional information at that time outside of the official press release, which when I asked to be sent a copy of that, they were only too happy to do so and got it to me within a matter of minutes via email. And as sometimes life happens, I ended up not reporting on this story at that time. And it's probably a good thing, because with everything going on in the gaming world, I would actually not want to have to milk this story for a second video. However, yesterday we did get another update from Wes Keltner, the president and founder of Gun Media, on the Friday the 13th forums. And that update confirmed what I suspected would happen, in that they would be discontinuing any future content for the game on a permanent basis. In that, Kilter also answered the question of what about non-Friday the 13th related content with a definitive no, and the reason for that, again, is due to the fact that they are operating under a license of a copyright that is currently under litigation, and that license was purchased through Sean Cunningham's ownership of the copyright. If Victor Miller emerges victorious from this legal dispute and manages to claim ownership of the Friday the 13th copyright, this would put Gun Media in a very difficult position. At that point, they would be forced to hopefully seek out a license with Victor Miller. However, if Miller owns the copyright, he could turn right around and sue Gun Media for their development of a for-profit media under a copyright that they did not hold a legal license to use. So, while I can understand how frustrating this may be for the fans of the game, trust me, that is nothing compared to the frustration that the developers must be feeling right now, through no fault of their own whatsoever. Right now, their very livelihood has been placed into a position where they don't know what will become of them. Their studio's continued existence could potentially hinge upon the outcome of this legal dispute that they are not involved in. It's not a pleasant prospect, to say the least, and I, for one, absolutely do not envy them. It's never a fun thing to find your life, your very livelihood, at the whims of someone else, and you're not having any control or any form of direct control of that whatsoever. It's not a fun prospect, it's not something that they could have foreseen coming in any way, and it's definitely not something that Gun Media or Nilphonic could have avoided. And this is not something that any gamers should blame the developers of the game for. Like I said, this is not something they could have foreseen. But as always, please feel free to let me know what you think down in the comments below. And once again, ladies and gentlemen, I am SidAlpha, and I'll see you next time.